Hola! Hey folks, it's Rob, it's Tropico 5, and I thought, hey, they haven't fixed the bug that caused me to end the last game in shame and failure, but so what? I like playing Tropico anyway, so let's do a new one. I thought we'll do a sandbox, and I'll take my dynasty out. We're going to start in the colonial area as we did before. I'm going to have the NARA-generated map. That way I don't know what to expect from it, but we're going to make it tiny. Okay, and let's make it hills. Let's make it hard, shall we? Yeah, let's make the resources scarce and the climate... Oh, God, how hard should I make it? Should I make it... No. We'll leave the climate normal. But we'll leave the economic difficulty at high and the political difficulty at high. Yeah. Do I want disasters all the damn time? No, occasional. Okay, all right. And let's get to just the aerodrome, okay? That way we have a chance of getting through the game before the bug kills us. So, and we're going to start with 5,050 people, and there we go. Okay, that'll do us. Okay, here we go. Here's our new island. What should we call it? Let's call it Robtopia. And it is a dinky little island, ain't it? Yeah. But on the plus side, there's not a mountain on top of it. Hardly anything in the way of resources, though. Yeah. Okay. So, yeah, we're not going to be an industrial powerhouse, are we? But, what we can do, and just to make things a little easier on us for bug purposes, let's see, there's the starting point. We're gonna... No. Come on. Just a bit further. There you go. And bring you over here. Yeah, there we are. Okay. Just for bug purposes, make it so that we have a segment of road I can destroy that leads to the dock in case my Teamsters are getting stuck. Okay? Because that may be a way of solving the problem without actually having to destroy the dock. So, let's see here. What do we got? That's right, we have to have time.
Greetings,
yes.
Old chap. I got a...
From the Dutch, thank you.
As right. You know, His Majesty is fond of setting fire to things. He has decided to build the world's largest bonfire and needs all the wood he can get.
Well, I think we can help with that. Okay. That's actually feasible. It's nice to have something. It's not like they told me to open up a gold mine or something. Besides, I'll be needing to cut down these trees for farming purposes anyway. Okay. So, yeah, don't knock down trees just to put in the thing. Right. Put that there. And let's put in our logging camp. Right over here. And those will be... So we can get started. And... There we go. Getting better at judging that. Okay. What do we got here? We got... Pig farm. What might be better? Cattle? Cattle would be better. Okay. And let's see now. What kind of food can we start out with? So we're going to need to do something. Let's see here. Coffee. Corn. We're good at corn. Good at cotton. Cotton's a possibility. Can't eat cotton, but you know, tobacco's okay. You can export cotton, and you can turn cotton into a textile mill down the line. That is a viable thing. Alright. Let's see. We want those trees to still be there for now. That road's not exactly where I would find it convenient. And... Yeah, that's not good. Okay. But we'll be moving into cotton, probably in tobacco. Okay. We could probably do a fishing wharf, actually. Yeah. That'll get us into something extra. Something to feed people with that isn't, like, from their community plots, and allows people to just simply have something else to export. So, I mean, we're going to be exporting logs, and we're going to be exporting fish. But it'll do. Now, what kind of trade can we do? Milk. We could export milk. Import corn. Export coffee, but we're not set up for that. Import sugar. Export logs to the West India Company. We gotta do that anyway. Alright. Yeah, okay. Won't even piss off the crown. It'll make him happy. Doubly happy. Yes. Okay. Hopefully the Teamsters will not become lazy and ineffective eventually. But, who knows?
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
I could really use that $5,000 right now. So, thank you. What we got here? Yeah, I could probably throw an entertainment building in there. Throw the tavern in. Make them fairly happy with the things. Yeah, make sure people have, like, somewhere to go and have a drink. What's
Technological
up?
Progress is the path.
Yes, we will want that. But first, let's get the fishing dock built. And how are we doing for employment here? Yeah, we're Yeah, still plenty of open jobs. Okay. But my understanding is that if you have open jobs, people will come to fill them, so... Especially for uneducated work. Yeah, some money on the dock. That's good. Excellent, my trade ship. What's up?
His Majesty wants to exchange wood.
You know it. You know it, you know it. We're definitely doing that. We're exporting so many logs. Let's see here. No, none of those edicts are appropriate at the moment. And actually, a small garden right here will improve the beauty of the area, which will improve the effectiveness of the tavern and of the housing. And hey, it's across the street from my palace, so, you know, even if it is behind it. Consider it my backyard. Yeah. And that's my petting zoo with the cows. Yeah. Alright, so how are we doing? Yeah, people are moving out to be in places where their jobs are. Okay, we got $8,000. Suppose I could put up the library? I mean, I'm a bit hesitant to spend money on a library right now, but, I mean, those educated workers are going to have to come from somewhere, and we're going to have to get research going. Yeah. I think I'll blow up that bit of extra road, though. This here? Yeah. So, priorities for me. I want our dock eventually. I'm not going to build housing during the colonial area unless I get a quest for it, I think. But I am going to... I want our dock. I want to get a Catholic mission going at some point, because I need to make people happy. We're going to need some defenses. Probably a newspaper somewhere along the way. Well, 17 citizens have arrived in Tropico. Excellent. I'm just going to invite the foreign worker. Scum that he is. Now, eventually, these guys are going to be knocking down the trees and be demolished, which is fine. They never seem to completely clear out an area. I don't know what the deal is. I mean, some things seem to be trees and some things seem not to be trees that look like trees. So, I don't know. Alright, so we're clear for research. Let's get the ranch upgrade first.
Independence must be every Tropican's ultimate goal. But you can't expect us to fight a revolution on an empty stomach.
Sounds like a thing. Okay. How much is that going to run me? 780 bucks? Okay. Where am I going to put the housing? Because that's really where we want the grocery nearby. Well, we are going to be expanding into this area out this way. I guess we'll stick it here. And then we can upgrade these houses here later on. And then they can just use the grocery instead of their gardens.
Thanks to your efforts. The revolutionary...
Definitely three more educated workers, thank you. Right, I should just be assigning some managers, really. What do I got? I got my money-grubbing son, I got my magnate son. Not really a job for him at the moment. Which of these has a high budget? 60 bucks, 40 bucks... 66 bucks. Actually, that's going to get more and more expensive. 72 bucks, though.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah, so let's put my son in charge of the petting zoo. Because he can skim a little cash for me. You got to start somewhere. Yeah, you can be a landlord, because you'll improve the nearby housing.
Your family's rather rollicking love life has led to an unexpected pregnancy.
Sounds fine. We'll build that Catholic mission. Okay. Where do I want it? Right here? Near the grocery? The other things? I suppose. Yeah, I could, like, put it right there. Okay.
Someone stole my manuscript and published it under a pseudonym. It was an autobiographical story about two men on a mountain who want to form deep male bonds. They even stole the surrealistic chapter where fairies prance under a rainbow. The circumstances behind the theft are
very
queer.
Yeah, cowboys eating pudding. Right. Next research item. Let's get, I have to get two of these so I can move on to the lumber mill. So let's get the sickle done. How are we doing demographically? 9 unemployed, so I should be building something else. Okay. Oh, the royalists really hate me. They don't usually hate me that much. That is some serious hate. Wow. And the crown actually likes me. So, I mean, wow. Luxury entertainment, I don't think so. Like I said, I'm not going to build houses at this stage. I could put in a new ranch, maybe? Pigs, llamas, goats, cattle. It'd be good to have something different. So, yeah, the goats fit better here. We'll stick the goats right there. And that'll give the uneducated workers something else to do, and it'll give us better exports and then our little more food variety.
As the air was born, all animals became quiet. A light shone through the skies, and La Chupacabra herself went to the crib and bowed to the infant. At least, that is what we will write in the history books.
Indeed. Let's get a tactician on side. You never know when one of those is going to come in handy. Right. Hair things that we determine are constant are black hair. And, of course, you have to wear the appropriate family colors. There we go. Not exactly the luckiest kids I've ever had, but you'll do. And you are Soli Robovsky. Okay. Welcome to the family. Right, so, let's see here.
Did you know that there are treasures buried on our island?
Yes, we will definitely do that. In fact, I'll just queue it up right now. Yeah, I'll put up tenements in the World War II era, and that'll house folk.
Jolly good, old chap. You've given His Majesty's subjects food, so now you should make them pay for it.
No problem. We'll do both. Extra rations. And no free lunch. There we go.
Thanks to your efforts, the revolutionary movement is...
And I will take more educated people.
While His Majesty finds your island's backwardness most amusing, he is now worried that it will hinder his great plan.
Well, that was my next step anyhow. So, there we go. It's all queued up.
Great news. While searching through the crates of colony supplies, we found a sickle. Now we have something that goes perfectly
with our hammers.
This will boost production sky high.
Ah, yes. Well, you know. Now, the manure fertilizer is not really useful outside of that until I have some farms up. Same goes for the forage pens. And I will be putting up some farms, but I'm still waiting for this stuff to clear out. Get working. Power saws aren't even available until the Cold War. Okay. Let's how are we doing? Five unemployed with one open job. So we're pretty close to balance. Some defense would be a good thing. Guard towers to help make sure we don't get killed would be a pretty important thing, yeah. Let's put up a couple.
Thanks to your efforts, the revolutionary movement is growing stronger.
Our research team, that is to say me, discovered it.
You discovered the shovel. Yes, I know. It's a rock. Yeah, there's no mine areas in my current visible area. It'll be a long time till I have the compass. Suppose I should send it on an expedition. Let's see. Go discover what the heck's over here. Planks, I think we'll go for the trigger. But I don't know, maybe foreman. Don't I have a union leader in my family now? Oh yeah. No, I have a tactician in my family now. That's right. Well, put you in charge of my guard. There you go.
It is the right, nay the duty, of every freeborn Tropican to grow his own bananas.
Fair enough. I was kind of expecting that would turn up. Now, I think
His
I need
Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Well, thank you. And I will take the mandate extension.
We just discovered the number of times you need to get hit by a plank to actually discover something. It is around 7, depending on the plank in question. We call this the plank constant. I am sure it will become very important one day.
Yep. Right. Okay. Let's get foreman, and then we'll go straight for red tape. Like I was saying, I'm going to need red tape to issue the urban development plan. So that would make the country houses a lot cheaper. Well, and the Crown sent me a big pile of cash. How nice of them. And how's my investigation going? Okay. Oh, we got an oil well. Who would have thought? Okay. Are we back? No, we're just coming back now. Okay. Well, if you're back, we're going to send you out again. And this time you can check out what's over here.
I understand you've begun mining operations, my good chum. I am sure your island holds even more hidden riches.
Yeah, you don't know the half of it. Like, how we have half of it. Right. We might discover a deposit from that investigation. I think we're going to find that one. So, that works out just fine. Let's see. We'll run the road. No, don't run it over the damn tree. Why don't you cut down the trees I want there in my way? There.
I sat with 3 other members of the research team. Suddenly, it dawned on us. We're four men. You get it? 4 men? Incidentally, we also discovered bad puns.
And now you can discover my fist and my foot in your ass. Alright. I do need an R doc. Just because 1 doc is not really going to cover everything. What do you want?
In a flash of brilliance, His Royal Majesty figured out how to fix all of your island's problems through the construction of a single building.
I was kind of expecting that, which is why I didn't throw it up right away, because I do want that. Lumber mill. Okay, we will stick it... Can I just stick it right there? Nope. But I can put it right there. Okay, then.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Well, please give me the treasury subsidy. Thank you very much. Excellent. So what we got here? We got gold. Oh. And this thing? Bauxite. Okay. No iron or coal yet, but that's not a big deal. I'll probably want to just cover that so I can use that area over there. And maybe over that way, too. Okay, the logs is done. Right. Fish? Really? Wool? Tobacco? Import logs? Fish? Okay. Alright. If it makes the crown happy and gets me a slightly better price on fish, I guess that's fine. And I can do a second trade mission going now, or I can add an extra ship to the fish. But the only other thing they want exported is tobacco, and it goes to the smugglers. Hmm. And I don't have any farms yet. Yeah, let's get my lumber mill built. Get it built. And you... go explore right here, because I want to be able to make use of this area. Crown sent me another pile of cash. Thank you very much, Crown.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Well, I will do that, thank you. Let's see, yep, we're hiring folks in, and... I could put a tycoon in. Increase the budget to maximum, increases the effectiveness of the building. But, actually, that's an excellent way to do the Teamster's office. There we go. They will now whip around much faster. How are we doing here? 2 months to get red tape. And then I think we'll get the trigger, because we're going to need that fort... Then once I have red tape, I'll issue the edict, I'll put up the houses. What's this?
Looks like the buried treasures I was told about were actually natural treasures. Still, any kind of treasure is better than no treasure.
So you want me to have a mine?
Red tape. It goes well with everything, and there is no limit to this stuff. People are going crazy over it. Lines are forming to get more of it. It almost seems like it is trying to grow bigger and bigger. All on its own.
Yeah, it has a way of doing that. Okay, so, yeah, we could access the gold mine. I'm not really keen on putting up a jewelry industry anyway, just because that's likely to be the only mine deposit on the island. Right, so if I put the mine in, and then we run the road... Okay, so a road comes off of there, and yeah, we'll just run it like that, and then run you up. No bendies, thank you. Wish you could just lock straight roads, you know? Okay. So that'll connect out to the mine, and that'll make the revolutionaries happier. And that'll give us a little small economic boost in the Cold War era, in the World Wars era. And let's see. I could probably put one of my plantations out here. Oh no, we got the red tape, didn't we? Yes. Urban development issue. Build me some houses. Country houses on the cheap. That's right. Okay, let's build them where? Okay, that's four. And then if I put those in the back, there we go. And eventually I'll upgrade those to proper houses and they'll just use the grocery. Yeah. Okay, so. How are we doing in the construction office? Doing fine? Doing good. Okay, and they're well off. Lumber mill? Fully working. Okay. How do I get my... Ah, yeah, okay, there we go. Put him in charge of the lumber mill. Skim a bit more cash. Why not? Come on, where are you building the stuff? Get building.
Our miners stumbled upon an oddly shaped ore nugget. You know, if you squint your eyes and tilt your head slightly to the right, it almost looks like a...
all right. So, what to do with the golden nuggets? Gift it to the king. Could do that. Sell the nugget. More money. Let's sell the nugget. Okay. So I'm feeling like we're not that going to be that far away from declaring anyway. And we still have our freebie. Yeah, continue to support the revolutionaries, get them in, and we'll be good.
His Majesty watched his bonfire burn with joyful glee. He enjoyed the event so much that he decided to hold an even bigger bonfire.
Well, of course. Why not? And let's increase prices. Hehe. But also, let's increase the budget on that so we get maximum output.
The revolutionaries are demanding that you insult the king.
Well, we will insult the king.
It has been decided that an insulting letter is the best way to get our point across.
The king is a beep. The queen is a erp. Or beep, beep. The king, beep. Let's go whole hog.
The king congratulates your attempts at romantic poetry. He says your piece is one of the better he has read in the last few years.
Romantic poetry. Wonderful. Oh, the houses are going up. Excellent.
Great news. We found out how to use the muskets the crown sent us. Apparently, all you have to do is pull the trigger. Our research was seriously hindered until we discovered you should not look into the barrel when pulling the trigger.
Yeah, if it's a musket, that's not really how it works, but I don't care. Let's get the newspaper. And we might as well queue up the Constitution. Alright. And I do want that fort. So, right. Put it where we can defend ourselves, right? Right. Right by the palace. In fact, we'll make this easier on me. Right road. Make me a small intersection, please. Thank you. And now the fort. And the fort is pointing that way. Okay. Just the way I want it. Right. For my personal defense. And the Crown sent me another pile of cash. Thank you, Crown. What do we got? We could export milk to the smugglers. That's a possibility. Cocoa. They want me to import logs. You know, we might import logs. How are we doing with this? Input. No, we got input. We're doing fine. Once these go, we might want to import some logs, but I think we'll meet our production quota of 10,000. Oh, one of the logging camps just went, actually. Alright. Well, maybe we will do that. Trade. Import logs from the West India Company. Okay, there we go. Because I don't care if we keep that industry in the long term, but in the short term, I want my 10,000 planks exported.
Someone must really hate us. It is bad luck to have one tornado on your island, but we have several. It must be a conspiracy.
Oh, good. Oh, lovely, four of them, all right in the middle of town. Wow. Ow.
I've come to dislike mining. It is a messy process that pollutes our beautiful island. However, the revolution demands sacrifices, even from Mother Earth.
Vita, you talk to me about this now while there's four tornadoes in the middle of town? Okay. Oh, good, a dock went. And the fishing wharf. And the lumber mill.
The tornado
and the cattle mill. Cattle ranch. And four country houses. And a guard tower.
For these tornadoes. Based on the data, the culprit is... me? No, wait, that can't be right. Here is the rest of the report while I figure out where I miscalculated.
Penultimo. Really? All right. Rebuild that, please. Repair the building. Rebuild that. Oh, good. My houses are still cheap, so thank you. We will rebuild these country houses. That was expensive, and I still need to rebuild the dock. Okay.
Presidente, after suffering 1,000 paper cuts, we have invented paper. It has print on it, where there will be a summary of important affairs, interviews with important tropicans, and a page with political editorials. This will give a voice to every tropican. Also, going to the little presidente's room will be much more comfortable from now on.
Indeed. Well, the planks are getting exported, which is good. Crown sent me another pile of cash because I was in a deficit. We'll get our automatic extension coming up, which will just see us through. And what? Well, I'm going to want that newspaper. Bink. Let's see. It doesn't strictly require road access, which is something to consider. Well, I could put a traffic right there, actually. Yeah. Right in the middle of town.
His most gracious majesty has dispatched your replacement, but he somehow managed to get himself kidnapped by vicious pirates along the way.
Somehow that happened.
Nothing to do with it. Nothing they can prove, at least.
Thank you, Lord Oaksworth. Your assistance is greatly appreciated. Now, remember that, your performance review. Now, let's see. Because we need to get the construction office into gear. Get moving, folks. Maximize budget for now. Just about got our planks output done. That'll be good.
Last night, His Majesty tragically died while lighting the world's biggest bonfire. The king is dead. Long live the king!
Oh, God. Okay, I'll take the one extension, and that'll see us through. Oh, the king is a moron. Oh. Right, we're getting our stuff rebuilt. Come on, get the dock rebuilt. Priority. Okay? Get on it. Stop milling around in town. Get to work. All right. So the mining profits will come along just fine based on a gold mine. I mean, it's not like... The other mine up here is bauxite, so I can't even get into that right now. I really should get some of the diversification going. Cotton, as I recall. Yeah, this lumber mill's gone now, so let's demolish that. And put in a cotton field right here. And our plantation, what do I want? Oh, that's right. We were pretty good with tobacco down here, weren't we? Can I fit that there? Yeah, okay,
Wait.
Excellent.
The leaders of the Tropican nation, in our desire to put into words the will of the Tropican people to follow and obey the laws of the state and maintain the traditional universal Tropican values of liberty,
peace, love, understanding, siesta, and hidden Swiss bank accounts,
to hereby sign the first legitimate constitution of Tropico.
All hail Tropico! Run that over there, like that. Excellent. Please get my other docks up and going. Thank you. Alright, we'll move you back down to normal budgeting. Actually, I got my money grubber in there. I'm going to leave you at maximum budget. We're just going to feed that. Oh, and I do have a use of that magnet. There we go. Put that boy to work. Okay, are we gonna set for trade now? Okay, we're back up and running. Alright. How's things in the almanac? There we go! Things are coming along! There's more revolutionaries than royalists. And the crown actually quite likes it, so it should be a fairly cheap independence. Just a matter of warming up a little on the popular support, and we'll be ready to rock. So this should be it. We've got 10 months to do that? Okay. What are we unhappy about? We're unhappy about healthcare. Can't fix that right now. Unhappy about entertainment. Entertainment is admittedly almost non-existent. All right. In our tavern? Do you guys like some more booze? More booze? I could put that in here behind the grocery store. There you go. Fertilizer will come in handy with our new farms, and the forage pens will come in handy here.
Presidente! Ooh, I'm getting ahead of myself. Governor!
Indeed.
The island is ripe for revolution.
Yes, we'll be declaring revolution soon, but let's use that few months we have to build up some resources and material and see if we can clear this mining profits item, because I would
His
like
Majesty's
to do that.
His Majesty's Jubilee is approaching. Present him with an expensive gift, and he may extend your mandate.
I do not think so. I don't need an extension. What I do need is another $280 sold from the mine. So I could put up an opera house, but is it worthwhile? It's for the richer citizens. Oh, the lighthouse. I never did put that up. Our library. Newspaper. So here's the aerodrome. We can't. Oh, I gotta go all the way to the modern times? Oh, Rob, you moron. Could put up a mansion. That way there is some high-class housing in town. Somewhere for the educated folks to live. Really? Don't have anyone working the cotton farm? Oh, there we go. Okay, it's filling in. Come on, 3 months. Get that ore out of here.
Thanks to your efforts, the revolutionary
Excellent.
Movement is growing.
Okay. I think that's going to be it, basically. So, let's go and tip things over.
Presidente! Ooh, I'm getting ahead of myself. Governor, the island is ripe for revolution.
It is.
His Majesty is most amused by your declaration of independence.
We will buy our freedom. Thank you! Right. So, wealthy voters? Secular state? Conscription? I like militia in that it needs high school soldiers, but conscription right now is important because otherwise we're just going to get invaded. Secular state? Atheist state? Kind of keep the religious down? Faster research? Or theocracy, go the opposite direction. Or we can go with the secular state and they'll be extra happy with their liberty. All citizens, wealthy citizens, male citizens. Let's go with just the wealthy ones, and we'll do things differently this time. You got your Swiss bank account? You can vote. Okay. Mostly that's me. Right, so we're going to need legalese. We're going to need to be able to get an embassy going. We might move into a power plant, but I don't know. I'm thinking we're going to be more of a tourist and raw materials kind of economy. I mean, in the sense of, like, growing things. Textiles, we could probably move into. Tenements I was going to put up.
Viva la independencia, Tropico! No more shall we wear the shackles of European oppression. From now on, we shall wear nothing but our own Tropican shackles. Viva el Presidente!
Indeed. Glad you see it that way, Lulu. Right. Let's get a clinic going before you start talking about how we're free of, like, health care. Yeah, let's put it, where do I want that? Where do I want that? I suppose I could stick it in right here. Yeah. We can put some housing in the back. Put it next to the newspaper? Yeah, we'll put it next to the newspaper. I'm also going to need a high school. And I'm going to need that soon. Right. So that should be a priority in construction. I want that high school. What kind of upgrade can we put on that? Mechanization? Yes, we want that. The fertilization, not so keen. But that's okay. I mean, it's for tobacco. It would degrade the soil quality, but eventually we could, like, build stuff there. I don't know. We're going to need new trade jobs. Let's see. Imports. Can export gold to the Axis. Okay. Steel. We're not set up to do steel. That's it. Okay. Well, I will export my gold to the Axis powers, because Nazi gold? Who doesn't love that? Now, what's going on, guys? Come on. Build my stuff. Why are you all hanging out at church? Come on, go build my stuff. Am I still in my edict? Yes, I am. Okay. 14 months left in the edict. So, I want to build a tenement, as I recall. Which I will just put down here by the docks. Three new citizens.
With the national treasury being at an all-time low, some analysts are saying that things are bound to get better soon. El Presidente stepped in to say that things will be allowed to get better when it is best for Tropico, and not a day earlier.
Indeed. Things are going to get better for Tropico, I assure you. We've been doing some investments.
We have a perfect business opportunity. We can make a huge profit off the misfortune of others.
So they want
we
cocoa.
We have a perfect business opportunity.
And they want sugar. What are we better at? Sugar. Could definitely do sugar in here. Cocoa. Cocoa could happen there. Or there. Right. I suspect sugar is probably the better bet. But who's who?
We have a perfect business
allies
opportunity.
Want cocoa.
We have a perfect business opportunity.
Access one sugar. Almanac, relations. It would be good to warm up the Axis a little more, I guess. Just keep everybody happy with me. Military loyalty is low. Part of that will be increasing the budget of my palace. And... right,
we
so if I take out sugar...
business opportunity.
Now
okay.
We have them right where we want them. Time for a little gouging. I really should see about getting myself a villainous laugh.
And yeah, we'll increase the sugar price and take the net zero result on the Axis. And that means we're going to need that plantation, but we don't have the money just yet, so we're going to
yes!
wait.
Yes! Our health care has become so bad that I now declare us finally free
damn
of
it,
the
Lulu.
Harmful influence of modern medicine! No more compulsory inoculations, no more tracking chips in our dental fillings, no more physician's oath keeping the cute doctors from dating you. Who cares about healthcare anyway?
Damn it, Lulu. You're not going to be happy when you discover the clinic I'm just building. But of course, we had to build the mansion first, didn't we? All right. At least there's someone living in it. Right, so we're going to need the sugar plantation, and I need it sooner rather than later. So, right, sugar. We can eventually turn that into rum as well, which is good. Probably put another one right there. But right now, we'll just export raw sugar. That's a service need on this. Pretty close to full. Okay. Not enough logs? That's right, we were importing logs, weren't we? We don't have any lumber mills anymore. Crap. All right. We don't have any logging camps, means build new logging camps or import logs. Can we import logs? Anyone got logs for me? Oh, I can't import logs. Okay. But I can also import logs at the default price. I don't need to make Cuba happy. I can export meat to the Allies, but I need 70 Allies standing. That's a shame. Need an embassy to get that kicked off. Well, while we're waiting for this here... time to fire everybody. And the manager as well. Alright, let's basically close that down. And what's the budget on this here? Okay. Yeah, those are not really high-paying items. The library. Time to put my money-grubbing son in charge of the library for now. Right, just like get a little of this construction done, I think I'm going to call that a video. Oh, 21 new Tropicans. Hehe. Paid 1,000 on debt, but that's okay. The Allies sent me a nice check. Got freighter exported goods. What's going on with the construction, guys? Come on. Get a move on. Get the high school built. I need high school educated folks for the future. You think I just want this place run by just a bunch of jerks?
I can see Tropico is becoming the tropical paradise it is supposed to be. More and more people are abandoning the hustle and bustle of city life to settle in shacks and live as one with nature. Right on, people. The beach is big enough for everyone. And my bar works 24/7 to satisfy all your worldly needs.
My negative spending's catching up with me. I don't like that. Yeah, with this shutdown, it doesn't cost me anything, so... There we go. Tenement. People moving in. Excellent. We would win an election. All right. Yep, the mansion's full too. Excellent. Not keen on this deficit, but I think it's going to turn around once we start exporting goods. Because that sugar can start flowing, and then... Didn't know logs and
President,
planks were such a...
I hereby with to for require you on the habeas cojones to execute a writ with an ovation decreeing a peres to one penultimo, hereby referred to as the penultimate party. Should you fail to comply, you shall thereby to for renounced as a tortfeasor, and the tropical people shall be taught the language of legalese.
All right, legalese. So, what do we want? Police state? I do kind of like that. You get a policeman to make people vote for you. Democracy is mandatory honest elections and happen more often, and you get no uprisings. That could be good. I do like happy childhood, late retirement, normal life expectancy, normal job happiness. I don't want early retirement for folk. I will move to a visa program because I do want more educated immigrants. So, there we go.
That's one huge wave, Presidente.
Oh, no.
And it's coming straight for us.
Now, why do you have a tricorn hat when you're on a tanker like that? And then there's two of these...
We're alive, Presidente! I didn't think we were going to survive that humongous wave!
Guys and girls, where are you going? The big wave is this way! Surf's up! Yeehaw!
My village... My island... It's destroyed. Well, I think that's a fine place to leave the video. Thank you very much for watching, folks. Hope you have a great day. We'll be back for next time when we have to sort out this mess. Bye!